guys. So I know it's been a long time, but I'm back with another video and I decided to make it a little bit different. So yeah, this is my braiding pattern, same as usual for basic crochet install, and she's doing an off-center parting. Okay, so now I'm onto my invisible part, and I have so many videos on how I do this and in detail as well, so I'm going to link that for you. I'm just going to slowly go through what I'm doing. So I'm just inserting my latch hook, and then I place the hair on top of the latch hook. I then close it, pull the hair underneath the cane row, and then I just put the bit of the hair that's on the left hand side aside, and then I just tie about 2 to 3 knots, and that's literally it. I'm leaving literally no gaps in between because it's a parting, and if I leave gaps in the cane rows, then you'll be able to see the cane rows, which defeats the purpose of it being a natural looking parting. Yeah, you'll see once I finish this process, but the knotless parting is basically the longest part of the hair, the longest process, sorry, because yeah, you can't leave any gaps, and as you can see, I'm taking very, very tiny pieces of hair. So now I'm onto the main installation, and what you'll notice is that I'm going to leave some gaps. I'm using the same technique as I did for my knotless parting, so the invisible knots, and I'm leaving gaps the size of the width of my finger, just because we can, because if we don't, the hair will be ultra full. But to be honest with you, it just depends on the kind of fullness you like. Even with these gaps, the hair is still going to be really full, and it's mainly because the parting makes the hair very full, because as I said, we didn't leave any gaps. So yeah. I'm crocheting the little tail that gets left at the when we do the cane rows. So usually I would like interweave it at the back of the hair, but I've stopped doing that because sometimes people find it hard to find where the start of the plait is. So now I just crochet it down so that it's easy to locate. So yeah, you can use that as a different option to the interweaving if you also find it difficult to find the plait when you do your crochet braids. So now I'm just about to cut and layer it. I'm doing very, very slight layering because the hair doesn't really need it. And as you can see, the hair's looking really, really full, even though we left gaps, because as I said, it fills up quite quickly. You don't even need that much hair. I think we've only used about 3 packs, or even, yeah, just about 3 packs, and look how nice and full it is. And the hair's just really, really soft. It has a human-like look to it, considering that it is synthetic, which is why I said it was only £30, because considering you know, that it's synthetic hair, it looks, you can tell that it's really good quality and it feels really good quality, and I've worn this hair as well, and it does last a long, well, longer than other synthetic hairs I've used. So yeah, so I thought I'd share that with you guys. Live it up, live it up.